If you have been thinking about hiring an SEO consultant, whether it's someone as an employee or you wanted to get an agency or freelancer to help you, or maybe you already have one and someone there is supposed to help you with your SEO, are you familiar with any warning sign? Are you sure that you made the right decision? Are there any kind of sign there that you should be more aware of that is making sure that it's helping you rather than damaging your organic traffic? Well, in this video, I want to go over some of the bad signs that you need to be aware of a bad SEO consultant. Coming right up. The number one thing I would say is if anyone gives you a guarantee of anything, that is a warning sign for me. It could be anything from guarantee you number of links or quality of links, guarantee you of traffic, or guarantee you of ranking. Frankly, if anybody guarantees you anything, run away. Run away fast. Number two would be if someone is focusing only on backlinks. It's important. I'm not gonna say it's not important. It is definitely important for SEO. But if someone only focuses on backlinks, then they're missing the bigger picture. For example, if you're not focusing on conversion and it's not helping you with your conversion, then there's no point getting new backlinks and increasing in ranking. And then if you get an increase in traffic, if it's not the right type of traffic, then that's also a waste of time if it's not going to help you with your business. So backlinks are important, but it's not the be all end all for SEO. Number three would be if they don't use any forms of analytics at all. This is a big one, and I've seen it happen to previous clients. And I'm not talking about using fancy tools and expensive tools. Even Google Analytics will do the job because it's free. And basically, it allows you to measure not just traffic, but the type of traffic, where it's coming from, which content is performing best, your conversion, your funnel, your all these things. There are so many things you can get out of analytics. And if your SEO is not using analytics at all and it's not tracking anything, that is a huge warning sign, because at the end of the day, how do you know what's working and not working if you're not measuring anything? Number four would be if you don't use any kind of tools at all. And obviously there are so many tools out there, and like it or not, we SEOs, we depend on the tools out there. You can't do the job without it. And there are so many paid tools out there, there's so many enterprise price tools which are crazy expensive. But you don't have to go for that high budget, even a medium budget, even a low budget one, there are plenty of those options as well. But even tools that are free, like Google Search Console, that is free, and really everyone should be using that for your own website. It gives you a lot of data that you wouldn't have been able to get otherwise. If the SEO is not even using that and that's free, then there have to be some questions that need to be asked. Number five would be if that person is not taken into consideration of any on-page SEO. And that could be anything from your headline, your title, your subtitles, your page title, the SEO title, the meta description, the URL structures, the image optimization, all of these things and more takes up on-page SEO. And they're important. As I said earlier, it's not all about backlinks. There are other factors as well. And on-page SEO is another one, and if not taking that into consideration, then that's going to be a warning sign. Number six would be if that person doesn't take content seriously enough. I don't know how people can expect to get traffic without creating content, the usual cliche of high quality content, but the thing is that is quite important and also allows you to kind of target more keywords, and this is especially done via the blog of your website, and this is where it can really help you with your organic traffic, target different keywords, and be more kind of customer friendly and target more, you know, user oriented content. And there's so many things you could do with your blog. And if you're not using that, then that is not really the best way to go forward, because not only it will help you with your traffic and SEO, but it will help you with your credibility and your authority and kind of build up that connection with your audience. Again, if that's not important, then think about why you hire that SEO. A scary one if that SEO doesn't give you any updates, doesn't communicate with you at all, it doesn't inform you of any information at all, being very, very quiet. That is all suspicious. A good SEO should always keep in touch with what's been going on and what you're working on and all these kind of things. And it's not about sending you emails or calling you every single day. It's just conversation via email, video call, just maybe a couple of weeks, every week, once a month, whatever it is, you will have your own way of doing it. But if there isn't any information, any update at all, then what are they really doing? It doesn't matter who you are. If you are an SEO and you don't keep yourself up to date, then you will fall behind. And you can do that by following information online from credible sources, to going to big conferences or popular conferences, going to your local meetups and learning from other people, being part of online conversation, whatever it is. It's important for all SEOs to keep themselves up to date, because everyone will know that things change very quickly and what works now will not necessarily work again in 10 years' time. What worked 10 years ago doesn't work today. And that's why it's important that your SEO is up to date as much as possible. So make sure you get that information about how well they do that by themselves. Another sign would be if that person doesn't follow the best practice. And I've mentioned to you, if what worked 10 years before will not work today, some of those are what you would call black hat SEO, which is a kind of not an ethical way to grow your site because you're going against the Google guideline. And this is why it's important for you to have some basic knowledge of SEO. You don't have to be an expert, and that is totally fine. But getting that basic knowledge will allow you to kind of keep up to date, just be aware of what's going on, and it will help you to make sure that your SEO is doing the best thing, following the best practice, not doing anything unethical. And the only way you can do that really is either get someone else to be knowledgeable about that topic, or you need to find out that information yourself, be aware of it, and just be understanding of what your SEO is doing. Otherwise, you might want to think about why you have that SEO in the first place. I've mentioned earlier about a person who doesn't look at a bigger picture. All SEOs should do that. And I mentioned before, if you're attracting the wrong type of traffic, then it's not going to help you with your conversion, and it's not going to help you with your, you know, bottom line, your revenue or your subscribers or whatever it is that is your overall goal. At the same time, that person will also need to think about what kind of impact will SEO have in other areas, and also what other factors will influence SEO itself. For example, even things like user experience and design, even the technical development, all the little things can have an impact on SEO. And even things that you'd never thought of, like what is your PR department doing, or your branding team, or maybe you have a customer service team, they can all have an impact on SEO. And that is the bigger picture. Not just the website, but in general, the overall business, everyone can have a part in SEO. And a good SEO consultant will be able to see that. And then the final thing that is a big warning sign for me is if that SEO outsources everything to someone else, and it doesn't matter where it outsources to, whether it's abroad or local, it doesn't really matter. Unless that person has a team and trusted sources, then maybe that's okay, and as long as they agree that with you, that is fine. But if that person outsources everything somewhere else to someone else who is not really closely connected to the SEO consultant, then that's a bit of a warning sign. It's fine for that person to outsource things that they are doing for their business. Like, for example, maybe that SEO consultant would want to outsource any admin work or any paperwork or anything that they're not good at, like design or kind of website development. Maybe that's not their job. They pass it on to someone else, which is their project. But if you have paid that person and that person outsources it, then that is a huge warning sign as well, because at the end of the day, you want to work with the person that you paid for. It's different when it's one person, a freelancer, then you know who it is. But in an agency, you want to make sure that you're working with the right person. Otherwise, if you don't know who you're working with, then what are you paying your money for? Make sure you know where your money is going and whether you're getting that back as well in return on investment. If you think some of these points are maybe relevant to you, maybe one or two points kind of triggered an alarm bell for you, maybe you want to open our conversation with your SEO consultant first. Maybe there's something left behind, maybe there's a misunderstanding, maybe the communication needs to be better, and that is all well and good and resolved, and that's it. But if that SEO consultant is not giving you the right answer, it's been a bit hesitant or ignoring you, or kind of being all wishy-washy about the thing that they've been doing, or just kind of being very laid back and stuff, then that's maybe something that you need to be aware of. It's a bit of a warning sign, and I think you should maybe push that even more. Find out what's going on. And if everything I've mentioned is relevant to you, every single point, and that is something that is happening to you right now, you might want to reconsider your decision whether you should continue with that person or not. Or you could do what I would do and run. That's it, just run. So I hope you find these useful, all these points, all these signs of a bad SEO consultant, because at the end of the day, a bad one can really damage your website in the long term and eventually kind of have a negative effect on your business. And you want to make sure that you catch that as early as possible if that's happening to you. If that is something happening to you, or if you have a story that you want to share, let me know in a comment down below. I'm really curious to know, because I'm trying to make sure that nobody has to go through that. And I've seen it happen to too many clients, and it shouldn't happen at all. It's just not fair. So let me know in a comment if you have any experiences like that. And while you're at it, just make sure you hit that subscribe button. It will really mean a lot. And also make sure that you don't miss out in any future videos at all. In the meantime, I hope to speak to you again soon. Take care.